I think the biggest thing from meeting Pep was seeing a coach passionate about the details of coaching, how to bring the best out of players, not talking the bigger picture and the state of the game and tactics or signing players. It's more that details of how he gets his game over, and he was so excited about it. He talked a lot about rugby as well, and how he loves rugby, how we have to look forward because we pass the ball back, and that's a great philosophy that he thinks that applies to football. As a coaching group, we encourage each other to learn from different sources. I've been fortunate that I've managed to get to meet people like Pep and get to great organisations. Another one that was very relevant for me going into an international coaching job was meeting former international coaches like Stuart Lancaster, Frank Haddon, Ian McGeachan, Jim Telfer, people that I look up to, and just getting their thoughts on the game in general and when they were coaching at international level.
Has Pep declared who he's going to be supporting in the Six Nations?
No, but he did get a signed Scotland jersey, so he was pleased with that. So let's hope he's got one eye in Scotland. I had 2 days there. I had a day for the match experience and then a day for the training experience, and got to speak to Pep. So that was inspiring. Hearing from a coach and seeing a coach that's so passionate about the coaching, probably the most successful coach in the game just now. So that was great just to have those moments and get that connection with him.
Are there very transferable things, or is it two different?
You always pick up things that you could use specifically when you visit an organisation, a sporting organisation that's very successful, and it could be the flow of the facility, what they're doing in training. There were definitely transferable messages that he likes to give to his players about off the ball effort, which are very important for us as a rugby team. No one's going to take that away from us winning the last ever Five Nations. It shows what a tough competition it is. It shows that other teams have came through and played really well. The last three winners over the last 6 years have been Wales, Ireland and England. They probably weren't the teams that were dominating when I played in the 90s. England and France tended to be the best two teams, and whoever came through, sneaked through in third, sometimes got a chance of winning. But now you've got five teams, really, if we're in that mix, about three teams that have dominated France with the amount of players they have, and the guys who did really well last year, winning three games and improving over the last few months. It is a very competitive and high quality tournament. Six is bigger than five, so Six Nations would be more impressive. Yeah, of course, it would mean a huge amount to our nation, to Scottish rugby, and it'd be, and you get more of a thrill seeing a group of team working for something and achieving it. So the boost we get as a coaching group when we see the guys going out there and beating Australia, is a better feeling than a player. You get that emotional high and the effort you've put out. But no, this would be huge for not just us but the whole of Scottish rugby. It was a very good year for us, 2017. The three wins in the Six Nations, followed by a win over Australia in the summer, and then a win over Australia in November, coupled with a very good performance against New Zealand. It was a good year. There's been a lot of optimism created throughout our game at national level, but also at other levels. Our sevens team won a second World Series. Our under 20s finished fifth in the World Cup, and our pro teams have played very good rugby and are very well coached. So, yeah, it was a really good year to generate that optimism, that buzz for the game. We sold out three games at BT Murrayfield in November, but now we're into 2018. We've got to build on that and look to get better. Wales have always had, in my opinion, the best defence over the last few years. Well organised, aggressive, big men that like to tackle. I know they're the best, or they were up there with the best tackle stats in November, so they've still got that. They're now passing the ball more than any other team in world rugby, based on November stats. So it should be an exciting game. An excellent defence, experienced players that are playing well, especially the guys that are playing the Scarlets. and an evolving attack that's looking to ask more questions of the defence. I love watching some of the players in France. I started watching more French rugby this year. I hadn't watched it as much when coaching Glasgow, and there's some brilliant individuals that come through their teams there, and they've been showing in the Champions Cup how well they can play. So obviously we've got one eye on the French game because it's our second game, and they will be very dangerous because they've got some brilliant individual players that I'm not going to name. I think last year showed how difficult it is to win away from home. There was only one win away from home apart from the games in Italy, and that was England winning in the last 2 minutes against Wales. So it shows the quality of teams. We'll have to play better than we did in November. We've created confidence by our performances. The players obviously realise what it takes to win games, but we need to step up at another level away from home.
You mentioned November. I think most people thought that you had a pretty successful November. What have been the workouts for the team since that tournament into the Six Nations?
To do things faster, to improve our skills, to defend better, to create quicker ball, all of it. You just there's a base to everybody's performance. So you'll ask every coach, and obviously defense, creating quick ball, skill execution are going to be the key ones, and that's what we're working on in training. From an international coach's point of view, it'd be great if we could have had the guys in camp from November all the way through to now. But they go back to the clubs. Fortunately, some of the guys are playing really good rugby at their clubs, which makes life much easier for us when they come back. But we're all the same. We all started this week on Monday, and we've got 2 weeks to prepare our team to be better than we were in November. I don't think there's ever been a time where the Six Nations has been such good health in terms of Northern Hemisphere rugby. Australia obviously lost to us, South Africa lost to Wales, South Africa lost to Ireland. So the Northern Hemisphere teams are playing better than ever before, which makes that challenge even tougher for us.
Why does it still make such a difference?
I believe it's because there's not that much between the teams, and if there's not much difference between the teams, then you do get a slight advantage playing at home. You got these are big crowds we play in front of, 60,000-70,000, and if they're giving you the energy, it gives you a boost at certain times. You got the familiarity of being in your home that week, not having to travel. So there are slight advantages. They're only usually seen when there isn't that much difference between the teams. But I'm sure every team this year will be looking to do better away from home to make sure that they quiet the crowd, that they can play their game like they can at home. Yeah, he's been in great form, and it was really encouraging to see him play well in such a big game against Exeter and starting that game. So he's improved game to game. This is his first year of being a professional player, from being a scrum half and getting opportunities to play. And he's only been a scrum half for a couple of years, so we've been really impressed by how much he's came on this year, on his basics, his understanding, that a lot of his job is to facilitate those around him. He must be one of the best in the game at support play and actual effort that goes into a game and off the ball effort. George knows he's progressing well, and we're keeping an eye on him, but there's obviously that part of the game he has to improve and keep working on. It's a situation where other players are going to have to go out and grab their opportunities. We saw that in November with two uncapped loose heads going into three very tough games against three Southern Hemisphere teams, and they were outstanding. Darryl Marfo really grabbed his opportunity, and Jamie Batty improved game to game and was outstanding into that Australia game. So there will be opportunities for other players in the front row, but we're confident in how they're prepared. A lot of them are getting opportunities to play regularly at their clubs because of injuries, so that helps. And something that maybe surprised me when I first started coaching, but now has become the norm, is when you do give players opportunities, they more often than not go out and grab it. Whether they've had the experience or whether they've been working so hard for it that it just comes naturally.
And you've got lots of back row players coming back. Stuart Hogg had a really good game. Greg Laidlaw is back as well. Obviously, Ali Price has been playing great. Is Laidlaw expected to come straight back into the squad? Is he going to be playing the Six Nations maybe more from a coming off the bench sort of role?
Do you think I'm going to answer that question? we'll see. Greg trained with us this week. He came back a week earlier than we expected, so he got all clear on Friday, and Claremont included him in their squad on Saturday, and although he only got 10 minutes, he'd obviously trained fully with them. He looks sharp in training, so he gets an opportunity to play this Sunday against Montpellier, and I think the team will get announced a few days later, so you'll just have to wait for that. Watch a lot of training. That's the one benefit of being an international coach. You get to meet more people. You got days where you're planning. Obviously, watch a lot of rugby. We have a number of players we continually watch. 30% of our squad play outside of Scotland. So within that, you watch their games, but you get to see what the opposition are doing, what their teams are doing. So it gives you ideas. But I'd much prefer to be extend international season between November and February would be nice.